Hi everyone, it's Asia here, and today I want to show you another way of adding color to your projects and how to create a layout a little bit on budget with homemade coarse grain paste. So let's start. I'm doing this project for AB Studio, so I'm also using AB Studio papers. This one is a beautiful paper from the collection in Wonderland. And to avoid warping, although the paper is quite thick and of good quality, I'm gonna still add a layer of clear gesso. And I've noticed, I tried a few techniques, and I've noticed that the best one is to spread it with a credit card or a library card, like I'm just doing right now. And right now I'm drying the page, and what's very important is to move the heat gun all over the place and also turn it upside down and do some drying on the other side. Like that the paper is really flat. And I'm gonna be using Aga Baraniak stencil. This is stencil number 19, and I'm gonna be using with homemade rust paste. It's a coarse grain paste I made at home. I was watching also tutorial by Olga Bielska, and I'm gonna give you a link in the description box below how to make your own rust paste. What I've done though, I made it a coarse grain paste, and I was just showing you a second ago, I used for that a modeling paste and decoration sand, which I bought in some deco shop. And it's very cheap, the sand, I think it was not even 1 euro for the whole bottle. And I mixed everything together and also added some magical powders. I decided to use powders instead of sprays because the spray will dilute the paste too much. So for the powders I used, not spiders, powders, here we go, my English. I use Mango Mania, Red Hot Poker Orange and Shaker Grub Gold. And like that you see I have a rust paste in the brown color. As I mentioned earlier, Olga, she made a rust paste with three different colors. That's a very nice tutorial also, you should see it. And now I'm using another stencil from AB Studio with VersaFine ink, that's vintage Sepia. And this stencil is stencil number 22. And what I'm doing here is I'm just tracing the numbers with a sponge. This image is not very clear, isn't it? It's very hard to read it because of the reflection of the light. It's a Lindy's Gang embossing powder, Gilded Burgundy Brass. And I'm sprinkling it over the rust paste, which is not yet totally dry, and drying it like that. I have also this small effect of embossing powders. And I'm gonna be doing some cutouts or die cuts, and I'm using collection from AB Studio in Wonderland, and also Be Gentle. And I'm trying to point out the pieces I'm gonna be cutting out, but at the end I'll change my mind a little bit. And there is also Vintage Elements collection, which is beautiful as well. And as always, I'll do my fussy cutting off the camera. So you see I cut a few elements, and now I am distressing the borders with the Vintage Sepia ink. And some of them I'm also distressing with scissors, and later I'll add also Vintage Sepia ink onto the sides. And I'm gonna be adding some wire to the project, and also small brads to keep the wire in place. And time for stamping. You cannot see because I cut the paper a little too much, but that's a stamp from Studio Light. And I know I could have done the stamping before adding the wire, because that way it's complicated a little bit more with the wire. But then again, I'm looking for a distress look, so I don't mind that much. And I'll change my acrylic block later for a smaller one, and like that I can still put the stamps more or less wherever or where I want it. For my focal point, I'll use the elements I cut out before, also a piece of torn paper from old book, and I will use also a vintage photo, which I got from one of my Facebook friends, Linda. Linda, if you're watching that, thank you so much for sending me these photos, they are really beautiful. And I'm gluing everything with tacky glue or with double-sided tape. Not actually a preference here, but well, I just started like that and with the tape and then continue with the tacky glue. I made a mistake here. I glued everything, not everything, but two pieces not on the good side. But as long as the glue is not dry, you can still change it. And I'm adding pieces of cardboard in between the layers. So like that, the layout in whole is not very flat. It gives this extra texture and this layering, which is so nice. And off the camera, of course, because when I'm cutting something, it's always off the camera. And I apologize for that, but then again, it's not super interesting, I think. And I'm adding pieces of lace, which used to be a part of my pillow. So I have a sentiment to it. And like that, it will last for some time in the altered version. And again, adding everything with a tacky glue. And when I'm happy, I can adhere everything to the page. I remember my beginnings with a scrapbooking layout, and I used to actually build the layers straight on the paper. And very often I was so not happy with it. There was a lot of layouts which finished in the bin, actually. So I prefer this way. I prefer to first do the focal point on the side, and then when I'm happy, glue it in the right place. And still adding some bits and pieces and working on it to add more texture and more interest. I wanted to make this layout quite simple, so I am not adding too many embellishments. However, this particular watch I really loved, and I think it matches the layout perfectly, so I added this one. And now I'm adding a little bit of script stamp from Paper Poetry, again with the same ink, because I want to keep this coherence with the between a green and vintage sepia color and brown. And this stamp, I'm using it quite often, I really like it. It's a stamp from Viva Las Vegas. And time to add some color now. So I'm using these different techniques of adding color to the page. The last project I've done, I also used this technique and I really like. It's very easy and fun to do. So instead of spraying or adding water onto the page and then adding paint with a brush, I'm splattering, and I'm splattering away happily all over my focal point, and I'm using different colors. Like that, it's much easier. You don't have to control too much where the paint goes, how the paints are gonna mix with each other. You just splatter and you wait what's gonna happen, and usually the effect is beautiful. I really like it. And I'm using for that Lindy's sprays. The first one was Moonshadow, Tawny, Turquoise, then Flat Fabio, Sandra, Sepia, and this one right now, it's Starburst Green with Envy Green. And this is the project I made for Rubber Dance with the same technique. So there is only splatter, and it really looks gorgeous, and it's very easy to make. And one of my final finishing touches is to add a little bit of metallic wax. This one is aged bronze. It has this lovely old golden color. And again, it works very nice with the page. And because I have these coarse grains, it stays nicely on the part of the stencil I made before. And it has this beautiful shine also on the edges of the paper. And I cut the part with the name of the paper, and I also distress this part, and I'm coming back to the whole page to distress it a tiny bit more. And at the end I'll add word stickers from 7 Dot Studio, paint chips. I'll add two sentences, and I'll also ink the edges with the metallic wax. And I will think for a long time where to place them. And basically that's it, my layout is finished. And if you like it, if I gave you some new ideas, please give me a thumbs up or leave a comment, and please subscribe. And thank you again so much for watching. You'll find all the important information in the description box below. Also, if you have any questions or remarks about my videos, please let me know in the comments. And have a great day. See you soon. Bye.